Erik Horne here with Maddie Lee. After the Thunder's 117-95 win over the Memphis Grizzlies tonight, Maddie, look, this Memphis team stinks. They traded away a lot of guys at the trade deadline. The thing for the Thunder was to come in here and take care of their business. For about the first half, they really didn't. They played down to the competition. Guys got into foul trouble, dumb fouls. But it's good to see the Thunder kind of take control of the game in the second half and push through and continue to play good basketball throughout the month.
Yeah, once they finally did get it going, that fourth quarter was fun. You had a ton of guys, different guys dunking. Terrence Ferguson had two fantastic dunks. Dennis Schroeder had his first since the 2015-16 season.
One dunk this season, one in the last, two seasons.
Last two seasons, yeah. So crazy. And you had Russell Westbrook make up for an early missed dunk. A lot of fun. You could see him vibing and everything, but Thunder really probably should have gotten that going earlier. You had pregame. Memphis's whole thing was like, we just have to get through this game because our team has been gutted and we just have to get through tonight.
Yeah, Memphis, they're not trying to win games anymore. They're 11 games, 12 games under 500. This is a game where the Thunder had to get through it too. They have a tendency to play down to the competition they did in the first half, but credit to the Thunder for getting their defense together in that third quarter to where they're able to pull away from Memphis, outscore them 32-19 in the third quarter. Russell Westbrook, eighth consecutive triple-double. People are going to look at the shooting. Again, Westbrook needs to shoot better. He really hasn't shot the ball well all season. I think he's maybe like 5 of 14 tonight, but continues to do some other things to get guys shots. Thunder got a ton of open shots tonight. They got 44 three-pointers. You probably don't want to take that many three-pointers, but they also missed a lot of open shots as well. They end up hitting 17 three-pointers. A lot of those are because Westbrook is generating so much pressure with his ability to get out in transition.
Yeah, once he and other guys started touching the paint first and then kicking it out and taking those threes, that's when the offense really started going.
Yeah, third quarter was big for that. Fourth quarter, Paul George gets going early. They get off to an 11-0 run. Dennis Schroeder's a part of that. Next thing you know, you look down, Paul George has 27 points. He checks out, doesn't even have to come back in for the second half of the fourth quarter. It's a pretty just, run-of-the-mill win for the Thunder against a bad team, but it's one that they needed going into a game against Houston on Saturday. Big matchup for the Thunder. Thunder is within two games of Denver for second in the West. It like we were talking about before we got on the video, it's a strange stretch for them because they really haven't been consistent in any regard defensively, but they turn it on at the right times in order to get away from teams. And, ninth win in 10 games, you can't really complain about the results. You'd like to see more defensive consistency, though.
Yeah, if they can get up and keep that defense strong throughout the entire game in Houston, could see good things for them.
Here's some post-game video from, do we have Billy Donovan?
Yep.
Sure, that guy. Billy Donovan, Russell Westbrook, Paul George, little Dennis Schroeder, Terrence Ferguson. A lot of talk about the All-Star game draft. Russell Westbrook and Paul George are going to be on the same team. So now Paul George doesn't have to lock up Russell Westbrook's bleep.